Cover Article 108 in this lecture, which pertains to joint sitting of both the houses. Joint sitting. Before we do that, I would just like to briefly touch upon certain articles. That is, Article 100 is relevant here. Another article which is relevant here is Article 107. Another article which is relevant here is Article 118. Article 100 says that all the questions, uses the word questions, it includes everything, passing of the bill is covered here, in the houses shall be decided by the majority of the members present and voting. Majority, save as, means if it begins by saying save as otherwise provided in the constitution, means because there are exceptions where this kind of majority is not enough, save as those exceptions, all the questions shall be decided by majority of members present and voting. This much only. And it makes a mention of either house or joint sitting. So joint sitting is also mentioned in Article 100 of the Constitution of India, which says that all questions, save as otherwise provided, and otherwise are those, as we covered in 61 impeachment, 67 is for the vice president, likewise we have for state assembly speakers, and we have 350 to 249. There are various articles which deal with other kind of majority. We'll deal it separately. Now coming back to this subject, so the joint sitting part thing is mentioned in Article 100 also. 107 is relevant because it says that bill shall be deemed to be passed if it is passed by both the houses. Both means Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha should pass it. Other than the bills which are covered in 108 and 109. So 108 reference comes in 107 also. Joint sitting reference comes in 100 also. 108 word is not, 108 figure is not mentioned. Reference of joint sitting is made. 107 very explicitly states that other than 108 provisions covered by 108 and 109, the matters have to be passed by both the houses of the parliament. Only then it shall be taken that it is passed. 107 also deals with manner of introduction of bill. That's again a separate thing. We'll not touch upon that. Now, Article 118 also deals partially with 108 because it talks about the rules to be made by president for dealing with matters of joint sitting in consultation with chairman and the speaker, chairman of Rajya Sabha and speaker in case of Lok Sabha. This article also says at the joint sitting speaker shall be chairing the session. Speaker has to chair. So this is just the basic part. Now coming to the essential aspects which have to be covered under 108 is, one is that why do we need it. The answer to the why is, if both the houses disagree, if they disagree, there is a disagreement, certain amendments have been suggested, or partially it is agreed, partially it is not agreed, so there is a disagreement on certain matters pertaining to that bill, or if the other house outrightly rejects, rejects the bill, of course it cannot cover the money bill. Other house rejects the bill, and or more than 6 months have elapsed after the bill was sent to one to the second house and it has not been passed. That house has not passed it. While reckoning the 6 months, no account shall be taken of adjournment and prorogation which is for more than 4 days. 4 days here means 4 consecutive days. 4 consecutive is the word used. So these are the 3 situations where the need for 108 would arise. And if there is a disagreement and meanwhile the Lok Sabha is dissolved, then the bill will lapse. But if Lok Sabha is not dissolved, Lok Sabha is there and there is a disagreement, then President has a role here. President shall notify his intention. He will just notify his intention for holding a joint session. And this will be a notification. And in case the houses are not sitting, then it will be a public notice kind of a thing, that joint sitting will be held on this matter. Thereafter, after this intention is made clear of joint sitting, after this both the houses, either of the houses in fact, shall not act on the bill, shall not act further, because that would be a futile exercise, further on the bill. It is quite logical also. And after having given his intent, he will summon the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha for the joint session. Joint session takes place and speaker chairs it, as I mentioned under Article 118, speaker chairs it. And in this, the matter has to be passed by majority of members present and voting. Majority of members present and voting. And of course, Lok Sabha will have a greater say here. And there are certain restrictions regarding what kind of amendments can be taken up while the joint session is there. One, only those amendments which are felt necessary because of the passage of time. The situation has changed, means new issues have emerged. So, which are there because of the delay. Amendments emerging due to delay, and the other amendments on which there was disagreement, the amendments which were proposed by one house not agreed by other, no new thing will be brought up. Only these two categories are allowed. And the decision of speaker, the chair, the person who is chairing, that is the speaker, shall be final on such matters. And then the houses will pass it. And once the notice, as I mentioned, notice was issued by president for intent of joint session, and meanwhile Lok Sabha is dissolved, joint session will still take place even if the Lok Sabha is dissolved in the intervening period. So this is all about the provision of joint session. Thank you.